Hello, Malty Maple Toffees. Ralphie here. We're coming up to the end of the series of these Whisky Reviews 104. We're now on to 104H. And I'd like to take this opportunity for you to hear a word or two from the guys who organise independent whisky festivals, because it's easy, seems easy, with all that whisky flowing, things quite straightforward. What is there to organise? But in fact, it's a lot of planning. And I've heard all about these spreadsheets and all about these hiccups and phone calls and the rest of it, but things come together. And a couple of guys who are thoroughly experienced and, in my opinion, pretty well organised about it are both Iain, the gentleman here, and Lawrence, the gentleman here. I'll come to yourself first, Iain. What would you like to say about the festival?
Well, 6 years ago, when Lawrence and I were in a basement of a liquor store warehouse enjoying dram after dram after dram, we came up with an idea. Lawrence said, could we do this in Victoria? And we thought, sure, we could do it, but we wanted to do it kind of our own style, and we wanted to make it totally a charity event, and we wanted to be the most socially responsible event involving liquor that we could make it. So away we went, and it took us a year and a bit of planning, and they thought initially that we would sell 75 tickets our very first evening, and then we managed to recruit one of our local dentists, and he came on, Dr. Jonathan Adams. He didn't know what he was in for, and they thought, as they say, well, it's all 75 tickets, and the first year was 475. Then it escalated, and this year we sold a total of 1,250 tickets for 34 events and ran it over 3 days, and we're very, very happy, and it's a great thing that we're giving all the money away to charity, and we drove 145 people home last night, too, as part of their ticket price.
Excellent. Now, that's relatively unusual.
Well, the geographics of where we live, it allows us to do that, and the charity recipients, they supply the volunteer drivers, and the vehicles, 15 vehicles, were donated by two local car companies, and away we went, and it was just plain fun.
Excellent. Thanks, Iain. Coming to yourself, Lawrence.
Hi, Ralphie.
What would you like to tell us about the hugely successful 5th Victoria Whisky Festival?
Well, it has been fun. It's a bit like a roller coaster. There's fun moments, and then there's those moments of uh-oh. And you mentioned hiccups earlier, and I don't know what you're talking about. There were no hiccups. Everything went flawlessly. But it's easy for us to say, you know, this and that and everything. But the people here at the Hotel Grand Pacific, they really put the polish on the festival. And they do the heavy lifting and the quality of the food and everything. And they really make the festival as the quality event that it is. So we're very pleased, and we're thrilled that they've supported the festival, because they really have.
Excellent. Now I'm going to come to both of you together here, gentlemen. Stay where you are now. Okay. I'll move around. This is the Ralphie Stiley. Right. Now, who's going to speak first?
Well,
who's
going to? There's always these little anecdotes that happen, and over the years we've had a couple. And 2 years ago we had the chocolate and chilled whiskey.
Right.
And the whiskey was encased in an ice sculpture, an ice carving, and the women eventually took over the chocolate table and the chilled whiskey table, and this gentleman wandered up with his glass, and he politely asked if he could step forward and to get a glass of whiskey and some chocolate, and three women turned around and abruptly told him to piss off and go stand in the corner. We will tell you when it's your time to have some. Point blank, and he beat retreat, and he was standing over in the corner, and he didn't know quite what to do. And the three women kind of looked back at him, and about 45 seconds later, they called him forward. And they said, okay, and the first question he was asked was, are you married? So he was kind completely flabbergasted. And his eyes were as big as saucer. He really didn't know what he got into. And pretty soon he was enveloped with a bunch of women, and the questions were flowing back and forth, let alone the whiskey. So that was one little anecdote.
Excellent.
Last year we didn't have the chocolate.
Uh-huh.
And what happened? We were somewhat, it was verbalized to us in no uncertain terms that it must return, so we did it again this year.
Yeah, excellent. A final comment from yourself, Lawrence?
Final comment, I think we need to thank Jonathan Adams, who did all the volunteers and organized them for the turnover of the master classes.
Mm-hmm.
We did 29 master classes between
11
and 11:15 and 5:20 in four sets of classes, 165 attendees at each hour. So and it went flawlessly, and they really did and Jonathan and the volunteers did a phenomenal job, and we're very grateful to them.
Mm-hmm.
And Ralphie, you can find us at www.victoriawhiskeyfestival.com, and we own both domains, with the E and without the E.
It's got to be done.
And .ca also.
Rightio then. Well, gentlemen, thank you very much for inviting little old me along to share this festival with you. It has been my largest recording series yet. I wasn't sure at all really how it would go, because we're coming into unknown territory here. But you'll be pleased to know that since I started uploading these videos, I have had over 2,400 visits to my site in one day.
Wow.
Which is a new
record. Very good.
And it's certainly got a lot to do with the interest that has been generated by these little videos that have been getting recorded at this excellent little event over the last few days. And let me assure you, gentlemen, I will remove my bunnet. Bunnet will go for the fancy dinner that's about to happen.
And next year, if you return, we think there's going to be a lot of people wearing bonnets in the,
really?
In the ballroom. So we'll see.
Ralphie, did you hear that?
I hear
a dram coming on right about now.
Yeah. I think you're probably right.
They
yes.
Just poured.
Time to wind things up. Now, two more videos to go, folks. I'll have a wee word with Jonathan tomorrow, and then there'll be the walk away, the final concluding video, as we're just kind of tying things up and concluding things here at the 5th annual Victoria Whisky Festival. Stay tuned now. Bye-bye. All done.
All right.
Time for our dinner, gentlemen. Absolutely.
Don't forget your bonnet.
I will not. I have never forgotten a bonnet yet.